This is a block collet. It's called Block HEX ER32 Collet. So it's, well, you'll see when you open it up. It's made by HHIP. This was ordered from Amazon. Again, a relatively, you know, thick but cardstock box, and they shipped it. They did the same thing. They shipped it in a padded envelope. And so if you drop, that's a heavy piece, and if someone's not careful and they drop that on the cement floor or they don't handle it properly, you could ding up the edges. But it looks like things are pretty good. So it has a steel hex base, hardened, should be, and then it's got a taper inside for the ER32 collets, like this, that go up to 3/4 inch in diameter. I think that's the largest one is 3/4. So with this ER32 collet, it's pretty well oiled, ER32 collet holder, it's got a hex shape, so you can grab it in a vise if you want to, in either like we, you can use it in a vertical orientation here, let's just show the vise, like, you can use it in a vertical orientation of the vise, or you could put it in a horizontal orientation like this if you want to do some machining on the side of something round. And also, they come in both squares and hexes, and I might end up getting a square if I see that the hex is not working, but I thought the hex would be more versatile because the hex can also go into a three-jaw chuck. Yes, three-jaw chuck on a lathe, but let's actually show it on this lathe over here. I was thinking we could use it on the kind of our standard lathe. If we wanted to use collets, we could just do this, put it in here. I think the chuck is about a little bit bigger than a 6-inch chuck. So the idea is that you could put it in these jaws and quick collet adapter where you can hold on to material using the ER32 collets, so that the main thing is that you would not be damaging the material as you would with these jaws. However, the centering of the material is not going to be as good as if you had a direct collet adapter, because the runout or the lack of concentricity is still variable based on whatever the runout is on the jaws of your three-jaw chuck. So three-jaw chucks are notorious for being quick setup but not having good runout. They can be a little bit off, versus collet chucks will be better. With this lathe, the spindle has a thread on it, so you can actually get a collet adapter that will thread onto the spindle, and then that will be a bit better. You could also just take off the chuck, put a face plate on there like we did on the mini lathe, and get another collet adapter that attaches onto the face plate. Here we have a four jaw, and the four jaw has this mounting with the, it's got the threads, and then it has this mounting plate on here. So what does it look like under here? It's still aligning to the outside of that piece.
Yeah.
When it lines up. Okay. So. But for right now, I thought this would just be a quick way, like when we want to hold material and not get messed up. But if you were like holding something that you needed to like flip around, you would machine one end and you would flip it around and then you want it to be super centered for the other side so that it matches up, this would not be the ideal way to do it, right?
Oh yeah, if you take the center of this part here, and like you said, the balance be good, right? This direction and this direction. So that would be, if you take the center, then when you switch parts would be perfect.
How would you take the center?
You put the dial indicator, yeah, and see if it is perfect.
Oh, okay. You make sure it's perfect first.
Yeah.
So which means loosening up these jaws a little bit, right?
Yeah, and go put in place and then
hitting it a little bit to get it perfectly centered. So it would take a little bit of extra work to do that, to get it perfectly centered.
Definitely.